stop it in permutation and combination is about grouping. Suppose we want to group some type of items. Like I have 10 items and I want to make two groups of 5 items each. So how can grouping be done on different type of items? Now items can be the same type of items or they may be different type of items. So grouping can be categorized into two, like grouping of distinct items and grouping of similar items. Suppose I have some chocolates. For the first type of grouping of distinct items, I have a Dairy Silk chocolate and a Kit Kat chocolate. So these are both chocolates, but these are distinct items. I can clearly distinguish between them. Next comes is the similar items. Suppose I have both the chocolates and Dairy Silk. These are the similar items. Now, how will you deal with these distinct items and similar items grouping? Let us see. Firstly, we will see how to group distinct type of items. This can further be categorized into two, which is grouping of unequal number of items and grouping of equal number of items. What is that? Let us firstly see grouping of unequal number of items. Suppose I have 5 letters which are A, B, C, D and E. Now I want to make two groups, okay? And these two groups will be, the first group will contain 2 letters and the second group may contain 3 letters, or vice versa also. The first group may contain 3 letters and the second group may contain 2 letters. So it is very simple. Just make the combination formula okay, which is 5C2 or 5C3. So this 5C2 means that I want to select 2 letters out of the 5. So that will make a group of 2 and the rest 3 remaining will automatically form the next group. So the formula will be either you apply 5C2 or 5C3, which is factorial 5 upon factorial 2 into factorial 3 equal to 5 into 4 upon 2 equal to 10. So 10 type of groups can be formed. Next we have grouping of equal number of items. Suppose I have 6 letters A, B, C, D, E, F. Now let us see a concept. How do we group the equal number of items? Equal number of items means I want to make a certain number of groups and each group will have the same number of items. Okay, now in the previous example for a grouping of an equal number of items, we had two groups. One containing 2 letters and another containing 3 letters. But in this case, we will have the same number of items in all the groups. So if any things are to be divided into n groups and each group has n items. Okay, let it be clear that we want to make n groups and each group will have a number of items. So total we have n items. Now if we want to divide the above mentioned 6 letters into 3 groups having 2 letters each. Okay, you understand? I have 6 letters, I want to make 3 groups of 2 letters each. Then in this case n equal to 3, a equal to 2. So NA becomes 3 into 2 equal to 6. So then the number of groups or the number of total groups which can be formed may be calculated using the formula NA factorial upon factorial N into factorial A raised to the power N. So here NA equal to 6, so factorial 6 upon N equal to 3 factorial 3 into factorial 2 raised to the power 3. Then we solve it. Comes 15. So that's how we group the equal number of items. So 15 number of groups can be formed such that there are 3 groups having 2 letters each.